Hello students, welcome to the third part of sustained release drug delivery systems. In previous part we have started the parenteral sustained release dosage form, in which we have covered implantable devices. Now next approach for parenteral sustained release is preparation of osmotic pumps. So osmotic pumps, these are the system which are driven by the osmotic pressure. There are various designs of osmotic pumps, and the detailed of osmotic drug delivery system we will discuss in separate chapter. So in this parenteral sustained release osmotic pumps, main advantage is that this system is enabled to get a zero order drug delivery system, means we can prepare controlled release drug delivery systems. The pumping device in this osmotic pump are linked with programmable catheters to permit pattern drug delivery, and has largely used for LHRH hormone delivery in animals to induce ovulation. As well as these osmotic pumps can be used parenterally also, as well as oral tablets of osmotic pumps also can be prepared. Next, it is implantable magnetically triggered system. In this system, it have a porous matrix with drug embedded or entrapped in it, along with a few magnetic pellets. In the normal course, very little drug is released. However, by an oscillating magnetic field, the drug diffuses out in pulses to the system, and we can get a action for a longer period. Next system is biodegradable systems. In biodegradable system, the drug is encapsulated in a polymer whose erosion is pH dependent. For example, the outer core of the coat is a hydrogel which is with immobilized enzyme like glucose oxidase, which convert glucose into gluconic acid every time its level rises in the blood, decreasing the pH and thereby causing erosion of polymer and release of drug. In biodegradable system, various kinds of biodegradable polymers also can be used, which will erode or degrade as the time goes on, and as their degradation continues, the drug will continuously release into the body. So now come to the summary. What commonly sustained action dosage form we are using in market? First, it is spansules. Spansules are hard gelatin capsule filled with coated granules or beads. They are marketed by the manufacturer under the variety of trade names. Means we are preparing microcapsules or microparticles, and that when we are filling into a hard gelatin capsule, it is called as spansules. Slow core release tablets. This tablet consists of a core of drug mixed up with substances from which drug can be slowly leached out by GIT fluid. Onto the core is compressed another layer consisting of drug and other excipients. The upper layer generally disintegrates rapidly, releasing the drug, which builds up the plasma level and which act as a loading dose. Thereafter, the drug is slowly leached out from the core, which can be called as a maintenance dose. The next approach is multilayer tablets. Multilayer tablet consists of 2 to 3 separate layers which release drug at different rates. In two-layer tablet, one of the layer is designed for immediate disintegration for loading dose, while the other remains firm and intact throughout its stay in the intestine, which will give a slow and continuous release of drug. In three-layer tablets, one layer may be for immediate disintegration, the other is designed to disintegrate after some time, and third may remain intact, releasing the drug at slow pace. Repeat action tablets. repeat action tablet as such they cannot be regarded as a sustained release product, but in fact they are used the mechanism of double or triple release. In this tablet, the second dose is released only after the first is practically worn off and there is no continuous release. So which is the specificity of sustained release, that the release must be continuous. In repeat action, the continuous release we cannot get. This tablet usually consists of a core and a coat. Initial dose is in the coat, which is loading dose, and following one in the core, which is maintenance dose. Liquid products. It is possible to formulate liquid products having sustained action by suspending coated granules or particles in a suitable liquid media which has no action on the coats of the granules. These formulations are similar to suspensions. This can be used for oral sustained release as well as for parenteral sustained release products. Next, it is quality control testing or evaluation of sustained release dosage forms. As we know that main intention of designing sustained release or controlled release is to slow down the release. So determination of drug release kinetics, it is the most important evaluation factor for sustained release dosage forms. Drug release is evaluated based on the drug dissolution from the dosage form at different time intervals. It may be as per the specifications given in the monographs. There are two methods of determination of drug release. One is in vitro evaluation or drug release method and in vivo drug release method. In vitro evaluation, kinetics or rate of drug release from the dosage form can be measured in simulated gastric and simulated intestinal fluids, in for which 2 hours the drug release is determined in simulated gastric fluid. And for next 6 to 10 hours, the drug release may be determined in simulated intestinal fluid. In vitro quality control test includes rotating basket and paddle type apparatus, which are same as that of dissolution testing already we have discussed. Now, the drug release data obtained, it is analyzed to see the dose dumping. That is, maintenance dose is released before the period is completed or not. Then release of loading dose, whether it is released within the time specified. Unit to unit variation, predictability of release properties. Sensitivity of drug to the process variables like composition of simulated fluid and rate of agitation. Stability of the formulation is also checked throughout the period of release. It may be 9 hours or it may be 12 hours. Ultimately, does the observed profile fit the expectation? That is the main goal. I will explain with example. Like in the monograph of aspirin extended tablet, the specifications are given. Means in 1 hour or in first 1 hour, the amount dissolved must be in between 15 to 40%. At 2 hours, the amount released or dissolved, it must be in between 25 to 60%. 4 hours, it may be in between 35 to 75%. And after 8 hours, the drug release must be more than 70%. So these are the specifications given in the monograph of aspirin extended release tablet. So when we are designing such tablet, it must fulfill this criteria. If it fulfills this criteria, means the goal, ultimate goal of designing sustained release dosage form is achieved. Then in vivo evaluation. In vivo evaluation is nothing but to carry out the bioavailability testing, means giving the dosage form to the patient or to the volunteers and checking the pharmacokinetics absorption rate by plasma drug concentration testing. And another or other evaluation parameters are also done as per the type of dosage form. See, for example, if you are preparing sustained release tablet, then the evaluation parameters along with drug release, they are weight variation test, hardness, friability, etc. If you are preparing parenteral doses form, then evaluation parameters may be your sterility test, it may be your leakage test, it may be your transparency test, and so on. And if you are preparing microparticles, microcapsules or microspheres, then the evaluation parameters along with drug release may be particle size determination, may be percent yield of the microcapsules, again drug loading into the microcapsules, drug and polymer interaction, so and so on. So these are the other common evaluation factors, they also carried out along with the drug release. These are a few marketed examples of controlled release products. These are the controlled release tablet of carbamazepine, diazepine manufactured by the various multinational companies. These are the examples of sustained release capsules, or we can call it as spansules. These are the examples of transdermal sustained release drug delivery systems. So here are a few references, and thank you. Thank you for patient listening.